Sports. And tonight, we'll see the New Orleans Pelicans as they go up against the Detroit Pistons. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. And now the opening lineup for Detroit. They've got Hill. Thomas is out there with Joe Dumars. Then it's Laimbeer. And it's Lanier in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And for the Pelicans, Ingram at the three with Williamson playing the four. C.J. McCollum out there with Gabe Vincent. And it's Hunter in at the five, roaming the paint. Hey, Steve, we have a long regular season coming to a close and a long postseason schedule ahead of us.
Yeah, it's a battle of endurance, Kevin. Physically and mentally, they go hand in hand. You have to have great... toughness to win in this league.
Now, here's Thomas. Going inside. Good D by Williamson. And so it's Williamson with it. He brings it up for the New Orleans Pelicans. Vincent finds Ingram. Hands it from downtown.
Becoming consistent from beyond the arc, it's completely changed how you have to defend Ingram.
Thomas with the ball. Now guarded by Ingram. Ingram comes with the double team. And now McCollum running the floor all by himself.
Yeah, how about the body control on that one? Narrowly misses getting the deuce.
And Smitty, you think about the years McCollum played with Damian Lillard. You have to believe they made each other better.
I totally agree, GA. They both have high standards, always working on their games. That's why they're two of the best guards in the league over the last decade. C.J. McCollum is the kind of player any team would love to have. He does so many things well.
Here we see the Detroit Pistons, Greg, a franchise known for stifling defense.
And going back-to-back with the Bad Boys, then the amazing 2004 title team that shut down Shaq and Kobe. And the Pistons have been great. They've had that defense-first mentality.
Here's Hunter. Fades away and sinks the tough shot.
And he's not going to miss many of those, especially that wide open.
And early on, if you're him, you just want to see the ball go through the net and get into some kind of rhythm.
And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And the word you got to use is explosive out there when talking about Grant Hill. He's one of those guys who doesn't wait for the game to come to him. He goes out and just makes things happen.
And the first one at the line is good. And so he's able to get one of two. New Orleans has come out of the gates quickly. Their last encounter was in Detroit, where they were able to handle the Pistons.
And boy, did that game nearly get away from them. But they were a little bit fortunate to have survived at the end of regulation.
They were extremely lucky. I think they took their opponent for granted a little, and it nearly cost them.
But teardrop falls in.
That's nice work, stopping short of the rim, just laying it over the top.
Vincent the pass to Hunter. Over Lanier, the turnaround jumper. Hunter's got his second basket of the night.
And I like to see this. They're calling his number early, and he's delivering.
delivering.
It makes sense, right? You're trying to get off to a fast start, and he can help with that.
And now the first timeout called here for Detroit. Gotta keep rolling here following the win against Memphis.
And a lot of that was game plan, putting guys in a position to succeed, particularly on the offensive end.
They understood what the defense was trying to take away and game planned a great strategy to take advantage of it.
Here's Williamson. It's hauled in by Lanier. Pistons trail by five. Here's Dumars, and easy 2 points on the layup.
Yeah, finding the weakness in the defense, that's the court savvy of Thomas at work.
Here's Hunter. Count it. Hunter's got six. About 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Dumars against McCollum. It's out of bounds. The Pistons able to retain possession here. Here's Lanier. He gives the team. Some steady offense, a bit under 10 points a game. And the ball's tied up, so we'll have a jump ball.
It'll be a jump ball.
So it's the Pistons now. Lambeer for three. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans. They defeated Charlotte in their last game.
Yeah, and I think the perimeter game is what helped them in that one. Consistent from out beyond the arc.
We talk a lot about shot selection, and we saw why. To avoid empty possessions.
Into the lineup for the Pistons, Dave Bing.
Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. McCollum, no good.
And this is what you like about his perimeter D. Never gave up and challenged the deep.
You see some guys, they just mail it in. They don't go out and contest it. Not him. He's going to compete through the entire play. You just love how reliable he is. Night in and night out, his offense is there.
Good on the three-point shot.
This is as good as it gets.
First quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Connects from three-point range.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
How often do we see this these days? Clubs answering each other from range.
Hunter. And good. Got the English that time as it falls. Hunter's got 8 points.
His fourth make in 5 tries, and we're just getting started.
It's good.
Just a smooth, clever playmaker. Isaiah keeping his teammates involved here.
Passes it to Vincent. Here's Williamson. Again, the Pelicans score. 109 left in the first quarter. Now a timeout called by Detroit.
Boy,
For the Pistons, Jerry Stackhouse has checked in for Hill. And Chauncey Billups is subbed in for Isaiah Thomas. Pass to Bing. 59 seconds left here in the first quarter. That's basket number two with his third shot off to a fast 2-for-3.
Man, he has come out focused and efficient. Love what he's doing at the offensive end.
Williamson finds Vincent. Good, and the assist goes to Williamson. Pistons trail by 6. Knocked away. And now McCollum running the floor all by himself. Williamson dishes to Ingram. Pass to Vincent. Got a piece of it. Here's Bing. He's coming off a 13-point game against Memphis.
And not only was he creating for himself, he was setting up teammates with good shots.
Ingram passes to Vincent. Here's McCollum. Again, the Pelicans score.
That's solid D, but in the end, CJ wins out with better offense.
No shortage of scoring here at the end of the first quarter. Pelicans lead by 5. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from New Orleans.
17.
Just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Pelicans.
Well, in my opinion, the way the three has been falling for them here early on, you have to think they'll keep firing away.
And I've really liked how they've moved the ball tonight. Because of this selfless approach, they are piling up the assists.
They've got Carter Williams. Robinson is out there with Sharp. Then there's Hunter. And it's Harrison at the two-guard spot. That's the Pelicans' 5. No problem knocking that one down. Stackhouse has got himself on the board with 3 there.
Yeah, with Stackhouse's ability to attack the rim, that three-point shot is going to usually be there for him. You defend him too close on the perimeter, and you're risking a blowby.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
How often do we see this these days? Clubs answering each other from range.
And so it's New Orleans with it, following Billups' 3-point attempt. Hunter finds Harris. And again, New Orleans with the triple. And we hear so much about young players and veteran players, Steve, but when do you feel a player becomes a veteran? Is it after a year, 2, 3? Like, in your opinion, what is it?
You know, Kevin, it differs for a lot of different reasons. But I think for myself, when you get that second contract, you feel like you belong in the league. I think when you get over 7 years in the league, that's kind of cut off to be 7 years or more, you're definitely a vet.
They recover it. Pistons trail by 11. Here's Stackhouse and the wide-open shot from Billups. Good, and the assist goes to Stackhouse. Billups has got 6 points.
And Billups is a shoot-first point guard, someone ready and willing to let that one fly.
And the basket by Harris.
That's a dozen straight points coming off the triple.
Bing, the pass to Lambeer. There's his 3rd field goal, and now he's made half of his 6 shots. And so it's Carter Williams. He'll bring up the ball for the Pelicans. Got a hand on it. And it's Hunter with the jam. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. And the pass to Billups. To the paint and stolen by Hunter. Carter Williams, the pass to Robinson. Here's Hunter, swiped it away. And now the Pistons, fast break. Here's Billups, and Detroit again with the bucket.
And that's pure from Billups, so assertive, firing away from the mid-range.
Pass to Sharp, takes a 3, and another 3 for New Orleans.
Out of their last 5 makes, how about all 5 from long range?
Over to the left wing. Back to Billups. Pass to Lambeer. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. And with the new CBA, Greg, free agent conversations can start basically the day the NBA Finals conclude. Do you like that move?
I think it's good to have rules that teams will actually follow. In the past, it was July 1st, and let's be honest, teams were talking to players well before that.
Now here's Carter Williams. He's coming off a 13-point game against Charlotte.
Yeah, and I look at his total effect on the scoring, both as a passer and a shooter. Incredibly productive.
Here's Bing. The Pelicans make their last shot over Sharp. It's tipped. Carter Williams dishes to...
Hold on! Hold on!
Kevin, you got to buckle up on that one.
You like the extra pass. MCW using his height to see over the defense, and he finds the open man.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. And now the latest from our reporter, David Alder.
Thank you very much. Cade Cunningham was the number one overall pick in 2021, and he's trying to take that next step. He says, I want to do my job. Something I really try to pride myself on is how much I care. What I care about the most is how I can help the Pistons win. Guys, they are assembling some real talent on that team.
Oh, they are, no question, D.A., thank you. Now, here is Hill. He picked up 12 points in their last win against Memphis.
And he showed again why he is such a sensational playmaker. Some of the plays he made were just remarkable.
Pass to Sharp. Shoots the three. Here's Hunter. And it's Hunter with the jam.
That's why you never quit battling on the offensive glass.
And that's a nice reward for his effort. The flush, perfect.
Working hard, beating everyone to the ball. He does this night in and night out.
And it's Sharp missing.
And typically, he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
And they recover it. Lambeer kicks to Stackhouse. Clock at six. Thomas with the ball, guarded by Hunter. Inside, Lambeer with the steal. Robinson against Stackhouse. The pass to Thomas. 40 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Pelicans with the rebound.
Meeting right at the rim. He typically converts in those situations. Not this time.
They grab their own miss. Robinson misses.
Great defensive effort. Just saved a basket.
You know what? This is why you never give up on a play. You don't know what's going to happen. Coming off a scoreless first quarter, he's found a little rhythm here.
Harris outside. And a great assist by Carter Williams as that one goes in. Carter Williams has got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. Puts up a deep three, and no good in the last second attempt this time. And the first half is now in the books. Pelicans ahead, leading by 14. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Michael, you guys have had it going offensively. How have you been able to make all of this happen from your position?
I'm just trying to get everybody involved, really. And we're just trying to work together as a team. We need everybody to win.
So far, so good. Thanks a lot, Mike. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it. A competitive matchup for New Orleans in the first quarter. And in one stretch there, they were up by six. The second quarter got a lot more exciting for them as they were putting up big numbers and find themselves way out in front here at the half. And, Kenny, what'd you see out there from the Pelicans?
Well, they've been incredible from beyond the arc. They're scoring the three in bunches, sinking them at a high rate. If the defense continues to allow open looks in the second half, I'll keep saying, fire, fire!
And, Shaq, what are your thoughts on Detroit?
First of all, where's the intensity on D? You think when a team is punking you like this, you at least try to put a stop to it. But nope, just keep giving up open looks, letting the lead get bigger and bigger and bigger.
And that should do it. With the second half about to begin, let's send you back to Kevin Harlan.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. We've seen a tremendous game from Harris.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him, really staying focused on quality shots.
And many of those quality shots have been jumpers, a very high percentage of those in the first half.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. And Detroit, looking at who they've got. Thomas is out there with Joe Dumars. Then it's Lambeer. That's Hill. And it's Lanier in at the five.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up. The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Driving the lane, Dumars.
Williamson with the block.
Hunter Williams feeling it out a bit, and it's Williamson missing. Pistons trail by 16. Here's Dumars, rejected by Ingram.
Wonderful defense from Ingram. Good to see him using his length to alter shots.
Here's Hunter. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist. 16 points for baddest one.
Love that they're continuing to attack despite being up big.
I'm impressed with their intensity tonight. They've came in focused and they've executed. Finally getting one to fall. They were 0-for-3 to start this half.
Carter Williams, the pass to LeVert. And it's off from three-point range. Here's Dumars. The 18-footer is right on the mark. Dumars got his second bucket.
And that's definitely a shot that he has in his arsenal.
Here's Hunter. Rebounded by the Pistons. Lanier's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Here's Dumars. Kept alive. Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Oh, what terrific hustle. He's got a nose for the rebound.
Great. He's ferocious when the ball goes up. Sinks the three-pointer. LeVert's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
And with solid size at his position, LeVert's able to make shots over the tight defense.
Second personal foul.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
And with numbers like this, how about 87% on the year? He's been somebody they love having at the line.
That free throw good from Thomas.
And without a doubt, one of the greatest small men we've ever seen. Zeke possesses the skill and determination to just take over a game at any point.
And both free throws good for Thomas. Pelicans leading by 13. Passes to LeVert. Here's Williamson. Over Lambeer. That's good from Williamson on the assist by LeVert.
So simple for Zion to use his body to shield defenders in traffic.
Pass to Lambeer. Here's the three. Buries the long-range jumper. Lambeer's got 13.
He's doing what he can do to pull them closer, but it's not enough. He needs more help.
A nice shot by LeVert.
Don't sleep on Ingram as a facilitator. Has the size to see over defenders and make sound decisions.
Outside Hill. Zion Williamson grabs the miss. Ingram wide open, hangs home the trifecta. Ingram's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Nimble ball handling by Ingram, allowing him to beat the D and find his shot.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. You have to like what we're seeing from baddest one.
The man has been relentless scoring inside, attacking the rim every chance he gets. Their defense has been powerless to stop him. We'll see what adjustments they make coming out of this timeout. That's the pass you want. Orchestrating the offense, creating for others.
Let's it go with a three. And another three for New Orleans.
Man, the triples keep falling, guys. That's 3 in a row.
2 minutes remaining in the third.
Shoots from 12 and misses it off the right side of the rim.
Both sides attacking. That was good defense versus good offense.
And Carter Williams slams it in.
I like what MCW does in transition. The long strides, he eats up ground quickly.
And there's the whistle. Illegal screen. And we'll take a chance now to honor the Western Conference Player of the Month, Baddest One.
And you just look at the point totals that he has posted up during that time frame. Just some unreal numbers. Hard to argue with him as the pick when he is just putting up huge stats on offense and carrying this team with his scoring ability.
Here's Hill. And yep, that's going to be a flagrant foul. Unnecessary contact.
And Kevin, I got to tell you, he's probably fortunate to just get a flagrant one there. I mean, so much contact. The officials easily could have gone even harder on it.
Greg, I agree. He better be on his best behavior from now on. One more flagrant of any variety, and he's out of here. Both free throws good from Hill.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
Here's Bing. Puts it up from 15. Hunter grabs the miss. Hunter's got his sixth rebound on the night.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
It goes out of bounds. That one off Levert. And while we have a second, let's see which squads have topped the league in assists during the past month. In the third spot, the Pistons.
And what stands out during this recent stretch is just how well they passed the basketball. I mean, this is a club that has become really unselfish.
Now, here's Cunningham. Scoreless thus far. Here's Lambeer. Finds himself wide open and drills it.
Assist goes. Textbook play by Kay Cunningham. He knows better to mess up that open look.
Mr. Williamson. Back to Carter Williams. Near the three-point line, it's Ingram. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. Ingram's got 10 points here in the second half. Bing, the pass to Hill. Now, here is Lambeer. And there's the pass to Bing. That three off the mark.
And you could tell he thought he had a little more space, but the defender was right there.
The ability to close out on perimeter shooters is so important in today's game.
Near the three-point line, it's Ingram. Doesn't go that time.
Wow, that's one you just kind of assume is going in. Tough luck.
And so it's New Orleans, out in front by 17 points at the end of the quarter. They've had such great ball movement and shot selection, and it's led to a terrific field goal percentage. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
And, you know, you can always count on him for at least a couple of these pretty assists over the course of a game. And this one, a thing of beauty.
You see why they trust him with the ball in his hands. He can make the simple play, and he can pull off the spectacular.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. The front court full of star power with Ingram and Zion. LeVert out there with Michael Carter-Williams. And it's Hunter in at the center, locking down the middle. So that's the group out there for New Orleans.
And just an excellent setup. Joe Dumars just plays with such poise and intelligence, the quintessential combo guard.
And that one's good, Hunter.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Here's the thing. He's a guy who will go on hot streaks for you over a number of games.
Some nice passing here by New Orleans. The basket good off the assist from Carter Williams. Carter Williams has got 10 assists here tonight. So active. And we've played through about a minute here in the fourth. To the middle. Shot from six. They get the rebound. And Dumars gets it to go.
And that's a lesson for the D. Fight harder on the glass.
Reason why, lack of focus, lack of communication, which led to second chance points.
Now Hunter, after Caris LeVert missed from long range.
And that is the exact type of opportunity this offense is looking to create.
You know, if you get the ball to the right guy in the right spot, more often than not, you're coming away with points.
And the Pelicans with possession here. After Grant Hill's three-pointer that didn't go. Williamson with the bucket.
Oh, man, I'm happy I didn't have to box out Zion. He's a low.
Now, here's Dumars. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. That shot off. Good D by Williamson.
He's had a tough time getting it going, and he's put this team behind the eight ball.
And got to push LeVert out of that area because he's very comfortable looking to score from there.
Now, here's Thomas. Passes it to Lambeer. And it's in there. Lambeer's got 4 points this quarter. Pelicans leading by 19. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. LeVert inside the line. Rebound by the Pistons. Lambeer's got rebound number 8 now on the night. And Dumars gets it to go.
And no matter what they've tried, the D just has not been able to deny them the ball inside.
Carter Williams, the pass to Ingram. A fadeaway. And there's Hunter on the assist from Ingram. Ingram's got 3 assists tonight.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of them.
Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over.
And as fans and broadcasters, we're not permitted to hear the specifics in these huddles.
No, we're left to infer from the adjustments we see on the floor.
And the Pistons making a change here. Stackhouse has checked in. Pistons trailed by 19. Dumars dishes to Stackhouse. Outside Thomas. Pass to Dumars. Here's Lambeer. It's rebounded by Carter Williams.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Now look, MCW is a tricky assignment. Manipulates his body on all these drives.
Thomas against Carter Williams. The putback. Hunter grabs the miss. Hunter's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. LeVert the pass to Ingram. And a bit of a battle here for the ball. The official signals a jump ball here. So, Steve, you were drafted by the Heat, a young expansion team at the time down in Miami. But if you had to choose, which city would you give an expansion team to right now?
I think Seattle and Las Vegas are at the top of everyone's list. San Diego would be nice because I love to travel there. I love when Vancouver had a team. How about bringing that team back, Kevin?
Gets Ingram atop the key. He's looking for Hunter and finds him. Fires the three. And Brandon Ingram hits from deep.
Their ability, again, to stretch the floor, particularly in this second half.
This was obviously a focal point coming out of the break. Look smart when the shots are going down.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. You can safely say mission accomplished now for the Pelicans.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought. An all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that. And man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And it's pretty incredible when you look at the body of work this year, guys. I mean, when they hit 70 wins, we were astounded. And then now, the wins continuing to pile up in what's been truly a remarkable and special season.
Really, they had their number this season. 2 wins, a home win, and an away win.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Baddest One.
He was extremely efficient offensively, got good looks, and really knocked down big shots all game long.
Yeah, and one of the game's premier agitators. Lambeer can bait the foul call as well as anyone.
Taking 2 shots.
And that one falls for Lambeer. And Sir Laimbeer nails both of them. Smart, accurate passes, Greg, are really paying off for them at the moment.
And also good off-ball movement. Everyone is paying attention and looking to create the best shot for the team.
The baseline J, and it's Williamson with the rebound. Pass to LeVert. He kicks it to Hunter. Over Laimbeer, and there's Hunter on the assist by LeVert.
And you know they feel good giving their fans a show here while taking care of business.
They're going to win by a nice margin. The effort was there all night.
So we see the Pelicans taking the W here. They poured it on tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home no doubt helps. And the execution was flawless.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much. Zion, you never let him back in the game tonight. How did you finish so strongly?
Just being consistent, not letting up after we get a big lead. Coach came and emphasized it at halftime, and then we just came out and stayed consistent.
Yeah, it was a wire-to-wire job tonight, man. And congrats on the win. Back to you.
Thank you, David. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, David Aldridge, Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening. Thank you.